Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Art Defoe, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Denny Brower, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Mark Menendez, and I've got that fishing affliction.
I'm Bobby Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Chris Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
I'm Shaw Grigsby, and I got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
This is Vicki Porter, the queen of crappie fishing.
And this is Harold Morgan, the crappie fishing legend.
Oh, get out of here.
Well, folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishin Affliction time, and welcome into today's episode, a certified fan favorite, Slab Hammerin Crappie, and a visit with the legendary crappie guide himself, Mr. Harold Morgan. And folks, he's going to teach you a lot so you can get out there and do some slab hammering. Today's Fishin Affliction product spotlight is on Fraybill's Easy Checker, and be sure to head on over to our online store to check out all the brand new Fishin Affliction gear that's there. Can't get enough Fishin Affliction TV? Then be sure to subscribe to us there at our YouTube channels, and at the end of the show, you'll meet the Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week. So sit back and enjoy the certified fan favorite as we visit with the crappie legend himself, Mr. Harold Morgan, and we do some slab hammering for some big old crappie, right here on Fishin Affliction TV. It's slab hammer time in Tennessee. Crappie time. Oop, clean my camera time first. Well, folks, sometimes the biggest technical issues on the water, well, they can be resolved by using just the bottom side of your shirt. It's slab hammer time in Tennessee, folks. Crappie time is here. The weather is beautiful. It is warm. It is that time of the year. So let's go catch some big slab crappies with the Strike King slab hammer. Folks, as I start casting that Strike King slab hammer, I want to remind you that this footage was from last year when the weather was very warm early on, and our water temperature therefore had gotten warmer a lot sooner. Well, how about that, folks? Oh man, looks like a dandy. Woo! Golly, folks, it might be a black crappie. Might be a black crappie. Let me bend down here and get him. Bring him in the boat. Oh! How about that for big ol' Strike King slab hammer crappie? Check it out. Is that a big old crappie? Now, black crappie, folks, how you can tell, of course, they'll have that black tint to them, but that's not always true. Sometimes they do have that white coloration, which makes you think that they are white crappie, but check out the number of points on their dorsal fin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 to 7 is a black one. 5 to 6 is a white one. So you can see that this definitely has 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 going into a 7th right there. And that is a big old black crappie right there. Believe it or not, I've got 3 of those things in here along with several big white ones I'll show you at the end here. But what we're looking for is that shallow structure, and we're looking to position our boat on that structure so we don't spook the fish. I'm on a really long log right here, and I'm casting to the far end of that log to catch the slabs. I don't want to get over them because I'm in really shallow water. Some people say it doesn't matter, and I've experienced it where it didn't matter. But today, I'm going to stay on that far end because it's working, and that is what I'm looking for.
Let's see if we can do it again.
Well, folks, as I'm trying to catch another good slab crappie, let's visit with the crappie legend himself, Mr. Harold Morgan. Now, Mr. Morgan has over 40 years of guiding for crappie, folks, and his knowledge base is so extensive, and we are honored to have him as part of Team Fishin Affliction, and he is also a member of the Fishin Affliction Sportsman's Hall of Honor, and he's guaranteed to put some knowledge in your mind and a smile on your face.
It's that time of year, folks, the springtime when the crappie will be heading for the shallow water, and everybody likes to go there, and when they're easy to catch, and get your bucket of minnows and carry them there, and don't forget, carry your bucket of Strike King lures with you.
Maybe I got them. I think I do. Oh, I tell you what, folks. Unbelievable, unbelievable. All right, let me see if I can get them. Is that another dandy or what? Just an absolute dandy. Slab Hammer Crappie on Old Hickory Lake. This one here ate it. And sometimes, folks, the bite is just a subtle bite, and sometimes it's slamming. This particular bite that I'm experiencing, they're liking a hop. And that one I really felt. The other few were just kind of like they sucked it in. Is that not a beautiful keeper slab black crappie? Unbelievable. Caught on the Strike King Slab Hammer. I've got a 7.5 foot ultralight Aris rod, 6 pound Abrasix fluorocarbon, and that US reel 180, man, high line capacity, can reach out there a long ways, just perfect. Got my Fraybill net, of course. I should have it out netting this fish, but I'm in such a hurry, I'm just bringing them to the boat. Oh, it's too awesome, folks. Is that just too cool? All right, let's see if we can get some more.
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying this certified fan favorite of Fishin Affliction TV as we visit with legendary crappie guide Harold Morgan and we do some slab hammering there in the wilds of Old Hickory Lake. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, it is crappie time in Tennessee, and this is Trey Davis, son of U.S. Army veteran, contributing pro angler, and meteorologist Mike Davis with a couple nice slabs. And this is Mike's lovely wife, Leela, with a handful of slabs. Now, while his son Trey and his wife Leela are catching those slabs, Mike stays busy guiding for big old largemouths just like this here. And judging from this picture, he knows what he's doing. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishinaffliction.com and be sure to upload them to our Facebook page. And maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild. Your pictures in the wild. At Strike King, it starts with the concept. Next, it's all about perfecting the prototype. Finally, it's about catching a dream.
This is a new prototype crankbait we're working on. Strike King. It's called the 10XD.
Strike King 10XD.
Wow! A 5-pass limit!
Perfection to 25 feet and beyond. Catch your dream.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Overloading your boat with people or gear is dangerous. Overloaded boats are boats with unevenly distributed weight, could be difficult to control, as well as more likely to swamp or capsize.
The capacity plate, located near the operator's position or on the transom of the boat, indicates the maximum weight capacity, which includes people, gear, and motor.
Avoid the dangers of overloading your boat by checking your boat's capacity plate, not exceeding the weight capacity, and ensuring that all weight in the boat is distributed evenly.
Turn the trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Ready Mix, serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, there's a lot of you that are fishing tournament trails out there, and there's a lot of you that want to follow the progress of those who are fishing those trails. And the best way to do it is right there at our Fishin' Affliction Facebook page. If you're fishing a trail or a tournament, feel free to post the results there at our Facebook page, and you can keep up with others like Slammin' Sam Lashley, The Machine Toby Lillard, Miss Laura Mae Cochran, and of course our very own Big Dog, while they're fishing the tournament trail. Our many thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail, and now back to Fishin' Affliction TV.
Excited, just excited. Big slab crappie. Oh, come up in here. Look at there. Another nice, beautiful crappie right there. Man, it's just a tank, folks. If you know what you're looking for, this is what the result can be, especially if you position yourself right, put on the right type of bait. There's all kinds of great baits out there, but of course, you know, we're blessed to be sponsored by Strike King as well as all our wonderful sponsors that we have. And I tell you what, everything that these folks make will catch those crappie, from the pole to the line to the reel and to that Strike King bait. Goodness gracious, another slab. These fish are just positioned on this long piece of wood, up and down it, and they're just working that bait by there, and folks, they are just hammering it. They're slab hammering it.
Well, folks, while I get back to chasing those big old crappie, let's sit down with the crappie fishing legend himself, Mr. Harold Morgan, as he tells us how he got started fishing for those crappie.
Well, folks, I'm sitting here with crappie fishing legend and fishing legend, Mr. Harold Morgan. Now, don't get bashful on me now, Harold. You know that you've been doing this for a long time. You got it for over 41 years, is that right?
That's 41 years what I've been in it.
Yeah. Well, I want to tell you something. Anybody that can do something for 41 years, you got to be doing it right, and you got to be doing it successful. And you got started way back when on Kentucky Lake, and yeah. What was the gentleman's name that you told me that you used to go fishing with?
His name was Jim Bernard. He was a crappie guide. One of the best I thought ever around. Jim was a big, tall man, sort of older man. He always wore a straw hat. Jim didn't talk much. He just sort of, you know, he would, he'd say, watch that stump. You're coming over it. Pull that line up. And if you didn't, he'd get mad, boy, and he'd, you know, he'd get irritated at you. So I thought, boy, if I'm ever a guide, I ain't never talking to my clients like that. And so I said, you know, one of these days, I never even thought about being a guide. Never even crossed my mind. I just wanted to catch crappie.
And one day, Mr. Bernard couldn't go.
Mr. Bernard got sick and he couldn't go, and they called me about 1 o'clock that night, I guess it was, and said, would you come down and go fishing and take Mr. Bernard's boat and leave yours at home? And I said, well, okay. I never cared nobody out for crappie guiding. I've never been a guide. They said, well, he said, if anybody could catch them, knew my places, you could. So I went on down. And I got the people and went around, got some minnows at the front of the boat dock. We went out. I got 65 crappie that day.
That's a good way to start your crappie guiding career.
Yeah, boy, I mean, I was thrilled to death over it, you know. But I figured that I'd been paying so much attention to Mr. Bernard 2 years every week. And so I figured that he can do it, I can do it.
Was those 65 crappie, that was the last 65 crappie you ever caught, or did you catch more after that?
Oh, I caught one or two after that. Not a whole lot.
Well, folks, right now, it's time to ask the legend. Harold, when you're fishing for those springtime crappie, how shallow should you be fishing?
Well, I'd be fishing maybe in about 2 to 3 foot of water to start with. And then if you don't find anything in there, move out a little bit. Just keep going a little bit deeper until you find those crappie. They won't be far off from that shallow water.
Stacked up on the end of a log. I'll tell you what, it's an amazing, amazing treat. Let me grab my Fraybill net on this one. Oh. You know, folks, not every day you get into crappie
like that on Old Hickory Lake. But it can be done. And I'll tell you what, when it can't be done, keep on doing it, and that's what I'm gonna do. Oh yeah, hey, and I wanna show you something real quick. Sometimes when you're crappie fishing, you get an extra treat. Let me show you something. It's not a crappie, but how about that? What a beautiful largemouth. Today's weather has been a treat, to say the least. But I had some rain just blow through here, and during that rainstorm, I picked up my KVD 2.5, made a couple casts. You know, I'm always saying, have extra things in the boat, whether it's for crappie fishing or bass fishing. Have a bait you can have stuff in the boat so you can fish for everything, and I sure did. Look at that beautiful fish. Gonna put this one back because I just wanted to show that to you, because what a treat that is. Gotta fix my rig up. I had to get the hook out of its mouth and had to break the hook doing it. I'll tell you what, those Mustad jig heads and those Mustad hooks, for folks who makes their own jig heads, you can't beat the sharpness. They are the sharpest hooks on the planet. I'm gonna get back rigged up so I can get back to catching these crappie.
Folks, I hope you're enjoying the certified fan favorite as we're doing some slab hammering and visiting with the crappie fishing legend himself, Mr. Harold Morgan. And in a moment, we'll be right back with some more fishing action. But right now, it's time to head upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter. Well, my friend Katie Blair, she's been at it again, and she's given me another tasty recipe that I know you're gonna enjoy. It's for Katie's delicious corn dip. And now for the ingredients. You will need whole kernel corn, cream cheese, green chilies and tomatoes, salt and pepper, butter, tortilla chips, and pepper jack cheese. After softening your cream cheese in the microwave, now we're gonna add in all of our corn. Next, add your tomatoes and chilies. Now add a little bit of salt and pepper. Now get this all mixed together. Now add a little bit of butter to the top, and we're gonna bake this at 350 for about 25 minutes. After this is finished baking, take it out, add your pepper jack cheese, and put it back in the oven for about 5 minutes or until the cheese is melted. Then it's time to sit down and enjoy Katie's delicious corn dip. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com, and be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe as well as all of my other In the Skillets. And folks, email me your recipes or leave them at our Facebook pages, and you might see your recipe right here in the Skillet on Fishin Affliction TV. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
As fishermen, we're predators, and fish are the prey. In nature, the best fishermen have one thing in common, their eyes. How do you turn your eyes into the eye of a predator? It takes 11 layers of lens technology and a new lens color to make the human eye emulate the eye of a predator. Stop buying glasses for the classes. Make yourself an alpha predator.
You know, about this time last year, these flowers over here were probably starting to look red, or at least I was probably getting ready to go get them and put them out there so they'd be red. But not this year. Winter has been more like usual, or at least I think more like usual, and we have had to deal with colder waters than we did last year for sure. Last year, by the time we got to April, we were looking at water temperatures well in the 60s, if not even higher than that, but not this year. Still, fish have got to do their thing. The crappie are gonna bite, and I wanna tell you about some lakes here in Middle Tennessee that I know are gonna be good this year. Percy Priest, if you haven't already gotten out there, you need to soon. Percy Priest is gonna have a good year. We know from recent studies at TWRA that this lake has had several good years of crappie reproduction. Great lake to go look at this year in Middle Tennessee. Old Hickory is a solid lake to go look at. About like Priest, almost as good as Priest in recent years, but Old Hickory tends to have some big crappie in it, and it's a good lake for you to go try out. And of course, Old Hickory Lake is a very, very long lake, spreads way out, got a lot of creeks in it, good place to go fishing. You might wanna think about Normandy too. Normandy down in southern Middle Tennessee, but Normandy down there, it is stocked with black-nosed crappie. So we know every year it's going to be pretty stable with the fish that we put in there, the TWA does. Go down there and check out Normandy. If you get one of those black-nosed crappie, you don't have to catch a limit down there to have a big mess, because if you get in four or five of the big fish down in Normandy, you have done well. You're going to have a good fish fry. And also, consider Woods Reservoir, real close to Normandy. It's one of the best crappie lakes in Tennessee in its own year. Should have a decent year this year. Has a lot of crappie in it. Not always monsters, but a lot of crappie, and you're going to catch some keepers. I know Rick McFerrin, a friend of mine, and I went down there last year with his son Daniel, and I bet we caught close to 100. They were just real small last year. This year, they ought to be close to that limit. So there's your four lakes in Middle Tennessee. Remember the limits. The creel limits can be different up in the northern part of the state. There's 30 a day up and down in the southern part of the state. The reservoirs down there, most of them have about half that much. So check out your fishing guide. Make sure you know the creel limits and go forth. We got some good weeks still to go crappie fishing in Tennessee, and there's four lakes for you right here in the mid-state. And tell everybody you learned about it on Fishin Affliction, and I'll see you next week right here.
Folks, on today's Fishin Affliction product spotlight, I want to talk about Fraybill's Easy Checker for crappie. This will help you determine the length of the crappie so you can fill your live well with legal-sized crappie. And it's very, very simple, and they have several models to suit your needs. Folks, this is really easy to use. First, you take the crappie and you put them headfirst into the Easy Checker, and you can see that the measurements are clearly marked, and there's less handling on the fish, therefore there's less stress on the fish. And these Easy Checkers are made out of a tough, durable polycarbonate plastic, and they rinse easily after use. Folks, there's no easier way to check the size of your crappie than with the Easy Checker from Fraybill, and there's several models to choose from. So pick you up one and go catch you a bunch of those slabs. And now, back to Fishin Affliction. Welcome back to Fishin Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, King Sailfish Mounts for that catch of a lifetime. Inox, the supreme lubricant. Wigwam Socks, the performance sock company made in the USA. Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts. Lawrence Electronics by BBGMarine.com. And Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Man. All right, number 12. Number 12. Number 12. Woo! Man, what a fighting fish. What a fighting fish. Right through a log, Fraybill net. Woo! All right, man, the slab hammer is slab hammer. Number 12. That's a beautiful fish. What a beautiful fish. Can't get over it. I get so excited. And can you blame me? Golly, that's awesome. Fish have seemed to move just a little bit, and that's something you got to start paying attention to. If you don't keep getting the result that you're looking for, you need to make little casts. And official position different. Sometimes when you catch a fish, other fish will come to it. Sometimes they'll push back. No, they don't always just do the same thing, do they? If they did, we catch them every time we go out. You know, another thing too, I've lost three baits already. This might be the fourth one. But I just don't want to go over there to get my bait. The first time I went way around and just did it at a different angle. And in doing that, was able to get my bait. But I'm not going to go over there because I don't want to spook those fish, because I want to catch them. So guess what I got to do now? Guess I got to rig, don't I? Okay, it's worth it.
Well, folks, as I re-rig by putting another Strike King slab hammer on that Aris rod, let's continue with our visit with crappie fishing legend and guide, Mr. Harold Morgan.
You know, you have been credited with being the, the expert in so many areas of crappie, but one of your specialties has been summertime crappie fishing.
Right, right. When I started up here in Nashville, I sort of left down and caught it. It got to be so far down and driving every day two or three times a week. And so Kentucky Lake, let me say this, Kentucky Lake is my favorite place of all places to fish. is Kentucky Lake, still is. When I started guiding, I just kept remembering what Mr. Bernard kept telling us, you know, about how to fish, that Kentucky rig. And see, the Kentucky rig was developed before we ever had any depth finders.
And that's a method that you would use to be able to go out into a channel or a cove and bounce around.
And your feeling of the brushes, you know, and stumps and everything.
And Mr. Bernard had that in place when you met him?
Oh, well, you know, back then they really didn't put out a lot of brush. There was enough stumps and all that you didn't have to. As it is now, we have to put it out because in these lakes, because it's gone. See, over the years, all the brush has disappeared. And so that's the reason why that I had to go out and work hard and put brush out. If I'm going to have a successful business, I've got to get out there and do my homework, you know, during the winter.
Well, folks, let's see that Kentucky rig in action, and let's see why Miss Vicki Porter is not only the In the Skillet gal, but the Queen of Crappie.
Inspired by the legendary Harold Morgan, who gives credit to a gentleman that did it long before he came up with it, but he learned this early on in his fishing career. It's called the Kentucky rig. Weight on the bottom, 18 inches up, one bait, and 18 inches up above that, another bait.
What?
B, is that your first?
Oh, that's a nice one.
All right, swing him in the boat, swing him in the boat, swing him in the boat, swing him in the boat. Oh, V. Go ahead and stand right here.
All right.
All right.
It's my first crappie of the day.
I think maybe the year.
It might be. V. I haven't really done any crappie fishing this year. Look at that. V.
Now, what we just did a second ago, though, is that we swapped off because you've never used a Kentucky rig.
I haven't. It's my first time.
That was your first cast.
First cast. First time ever using the Kentucky rig.
And
look, he hit the second bait. He hit the bait on the top.
Is that awesome or what, V?
That's awesome. I love catching crappie.
I know that you, because why?
Because I proclaim myself as the crappie queen.
When you catch fish like that, I believe you're wearing the crown on top of your head. That's awesome. Let's take a quick picture and we'll put him in the lab book.
All right, sounds good.
Well, folks, one of my favorite things to do is to visit with people who have done things for such a very long time, and the opportunity to visit with crappie fishing legend Harold Morgan has sincerely been one of the highlights for me since we've been doing Fishin' Affliction television. A wonderful man, a funny man, a knowledgeable man, Mr. Morgan is one of those people that you could sit around all day talking with and never get tired of the conversation that you're carrying on with him, whether it's fishing, music, or whatever else. Any time that you get to spend with Mr. Harold Morgan is truly a blessed time. And on next week's episode, we're happy to bring to you part two of the certified fan favorite visit with Harold Morgan, Slab Hammerin Crappie Part 2, as Mr. Morgan is going to share some more secrets and techniques about catching these big old slab crappie in the wintertime, summertime, springtime. It doesn't matter. Any time is a great time to go slab hammering, especially when you can learn the tips from legendary crappie guide Harold Morgan. Our thanks to all the fans of Fishin' Affliction Television who have contacted us over the last year that have let us know how much they've enjoyed this visit with Harold Morgan and have made this a certified fan favorite. So tune in to Fishin' Affliction TV next week and you'll see.
That's number two. Look how big it is, too.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is
James Roberts.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt the Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
All right, 3, 2. Did you remember what it was?
Yeah, I knew, but I didn't. I thought you were gonna have a light coming on.
It's right back here.
Oh, I can't see it.
You ain't gonna get to see it.
Okay, that's all right. You just, that's what I'm always used to looking at, you know,
yeah,
the red.
Is-